transfer station in Kingston with Heather Roberts, Director of Solid Waste for the City of Kingston. Good morning.
Good morning.
Heather, we are here to talk about waste, to talk about recycling, and let's get right to it. You've got some bags that you've brought out. We're going to take a look at them.
Yeah, sure. So we're at the waste transfer station this morning where all the garbage from every household in Kingston comes to. We're taking a look at the composition of things in the garbage. So when we talk about how we could be doing better, it's really important to take a look at what is in the garbage that we're sending to landfill today. Very quickly in here, we see coffee cups, coffee lids. There's a whole bag of organics. Not sure why that didn't go into the green bin. Over here, we've got other containers that could have gone into the blue box. We've got cloth, other organics in here.
Where did the cloth go?
Cloth could go into a clothing donation box. There's many of them across the city. We have one at the Kingston Area Recycling Center right there, and it can be recycled. So when we're looking at this stuff, we're trying to figure out, you know, how much of what we send to landfill could have been diverted in our green bin or our blue and gray box recycling program.
Okay, and you're seeing this a lot. This is fairly typical, because I think a lot of people think that, well, I'm doing my part, I'm recycling, and so what more are we not doing?
Well, we're not really sure, and that's what we're embarking on here. What we know is that people are doing a really great job. We've got a 60% waste diversion rate. We've had that for a few years, but now we have flatlined. We're not seeing that number increase at all, but council has a goal for us to achieve a 65% waste diversion rate by 2025. And so what we want to know is, you know, what kind of program and policy changes need to happen to get these items out of bags going to landfill and in the blue and gray box and green bin programs.
And are all households in Kingston, are they equipped with green, blue, gray bins, Heather?
Yeah, we hope so. And if people aren't, then they can come and see us at the Kingston Area Recycling Center. We have blue and gray and green bins there, and we can help people get started.
And also, why do we, you know, I'd like you to make the direct link here, because Kingston has taken a bold new step, as a lot of people are aware, in terms of climate change. Make the link for us from what you're showing us today to the environment.
So the link and why we're constantly talking about diverting waste from landfill is, once waste is gone into a landfill, we bury it, we starve it of oxygen, it creates greenhouse gas emissions that have to be released into the environment, basically. And if we can recover those materials out of garbage bags, especially organics, which contribute to a high level of methane gas, which is the worst greenhouse gas emission out there, then we can do our part for the environment and stop the release of those greenhouse gas emissions.
Now, you mentioned, Heather, that a lot of people are really, like Kingston is in general doing a very good job. But I think what you're telling us is that there's a bigger conversation here. It's almost as if we have to change our attitudes, the way we shop, that maybe not buying so much.
Yeah, I think that that's a really good point of when we're doing waste composition audits and we're seeing a lot of organics, what we would expect to see is orange peels, potato peels, watermelon rinds, meat bones, things that aren't edible. Like, they were never intended to be eaten, but they are organic. But what we see is a lot of wasted food. And so is there a bigger conversation that needs to be held about how do we reduce the food waste? How do we reduce the waste that we even put out? So even if waste can go into the green bin and be turned into compost or be put in a blue and gray box and be recycled into a new product, all of that still requires management. And how do we reduce that amount of waste that needs to be managed in the first place?
Heather, you're going to be talking to people in the community, hearing from people in the weeks and months to come.
That's right. We're going to be starting on a public engagement and consultation on the next strategies that we need to implement to reach our goal of 65% waste diversion. So stay tuned. We're going to have a project page on the city's website as well as the Get Involved page. We're going to be looking for people to volunteer their time on focus groups, come out to some open houses. We want to hear from people about what kind of strategies Kingston should implement, programs and policies to make sure that all waste that can be diverted is diverted.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Heather Roberts, Head of Director of Solid Waste for the City of Kingston. I'm JC Kenny. Thank you so much for watching.